Mark Williams has won the world title twice, Neil Robertson once. Robertson currently 7th in the world rankings, Williams 15th. A little bit off the beam with the first attempt at a long pot. Played it in such a way that he was going to cover the red to right corner, but this one is on with a thin cut. Well, there was one red out, but with the pink and black both tied up, that was certainly
eight.
The right choice to go into the bunch. If the two reds close together by the side of the bunch are a plant, Robertson will be very careful about playing any safety shot to the balk area. That's why he's contented himself with a negative safety. Now, has Williams covered that potential plant? Maybe not, although it's a three ball plant now. Didn't go in though. Knew that the cue ball would be coming into balk off the bunch, but he didn't know exactly where, so he's left himself something of a problem here. Doesn't want to attempt a colour and leave the red to left corner. managed to pop that tricky green. He's all right if pink goes to middle. Oh dear. An absolutely dead basic pink eludes Williams. And with so many loose reds, I've got to put that down as a frame winning chance. As this is. Robertson started the season in great style, winning the
21
Riga Masters out in Latvia, but he's been rather quiet since then. Two more reds would see Robertson pass the post in this opening frame.
46.
Well, that was frame ball, and I didn't expect him to miss it. Not a good safety from Williams, sending the red into the pink, leaving a possible to right middle. So Robertson has exploited a couple of errors from Williams in this frame. First was a pink from its spot at point blank range, and the second safety error.
33 in
the
first frame.
So Neil Robertson leads Mark Williams by a frame to nil. Rob Spencer is the referee. Re-racking the balls. Comes from Stockport. Used to be a policeman.
Second frame. Neil Robertson to back.
Well, not quite sure how that happened. But at least the red he's brought down is not easy. not an attempted pot. Seven groups in Championship League, seven players in each group, and the winners of each group go into the winners group on March the 1st and 2nd. Each group takes 2 days, and yesterday there were so many 3-2s that there was continuous play from 11 o'clock in the morning till 11 at night. Middle distance, wouldn't usually miss that. Not quite. May have played for the red on the black spot though, rather than the red that he just cannoned. Robertson recently recalled standing in a dole queue in Australia, and because it was quite a long queue, it gave him time to think that it wasn't for him and that he would give snooker another go. And since then, he's won over £3 million in prize money. Most of the year in Cambridge. Rather a dead contact, that. So that's why he's not on pink to corner. And the rescue shot fails. too difficult, too risky to attempt to pot that red. Knew that the red he played was opening the bunch. Still can't get going. That sort of half ballish pot is usually meat and drink to him. Well, at least that's brought the blue out. Although it's not clear that he can reach the potting angle. If he can, it's very tight. Played that poorly though. It was a decent yellow to keep the break going. The black has been safe the whole frame. Cannon was a good idea. Not immediately clear though whether he can get through to pot the black. Seems as if he can.
Quincy Sam.
Flick off the black sport black ball position. But what a good pink that was to middle. The standard of middle pocket potting these days, as far as the top players are concerned, is phenomenal. Robertson misses that tricky one along the rail though. Not having quite clinched the frame. Williams coming to the table 49 behind, has it all to do. I think from Williams' point of view, the bounce off the side cushion was unexpectedly springy. Wanted to leave the cue ball nearer the left-hand side cushion. Over hit again.
Nine.
Human error, I think, that time. Still 40 behind, but forced into a safety, or at least an intended safety. Intended to roll up behind the green. Easy for Robertson to lay a snooker here. Puts the red anywhere over the left hand side of the table. And it's a snooker. Not so much to gain points, but tactical advantage. Looks as if he'll be happy with that. That escape. Chance for a winning clearance then.
Eight. Nine.
tee shot. If he pots this, he should win the frame. But there's a bit of distance involved. Williams can still win with all the colours. Played that well, that tactical snooker. Yes, Williams quite right to exercise his option of having the cue ball replaced in its original position. The yellow was on, but it wasn't easy, and even more difficult to get position on the green. There again, yellow is on to middle, but at the wrong angle to get green ball position.
Is it still somewhere around there?
Yeah, you missed it. You missed the yellow on that side, haven't you?
Is it somewhere?
This way?
Yeah.
Yeah, Neil?
Third time successful, and not all that bad, because length of the table from tight on the rail, this would be a good pot. Not attempted. Robertson's lead has been reduced to 15 because of the penalty points he's conceded. excellent shot. And a friendly angle to roll it in the
fine
trademark Williams way. A great roller of a ball he is. Couldn't get really close on the pink, and he needs black in addition. I think in the end he tried to cannon the black, because he certainly couldn't hold for it. And an excellent cut with the rest completes Williams's clearance of the colours as he wins on the black to equalise at 1-all. Quick run through of the financial aspects of the competition. They're playing for £100 per frame in the round robin stage. Top four in the seven man group go into the semi-finals, the group semi-finals that is, tomorrow evening. And group winner will receive an extra £3,000. Runner up 2,000 and the losing semi finalist 1,000. The group winner proceeds to the winners' group. The runner up, two semi finalists, and the fifth place finisher in the group are entitled to come back in at group three, which starts next Monday. Dreadful break off shot. Whatever you do, don't hit the blue. well knew that he was spreading the reds, wasn't quite sure what colour he was going to finish on. Green to middle looks okay, and now that he's opened the reds, he could win the frame at this visit, thus exploiting Williams's bungled break-off shot to the maximum. Just about okay for his intended red. It may be that Robinson can't get to the centre of the cue ball with the red he wants to take between the pink and black, but this is okay, albeit with the rest. The only snag is that there are a couple of possible ways he could snooker himself on the pink to right corner, which would be his preferred next shot. And that's one of them. Meant to leave the cue ball between the two reds. Solid long pot.
56.
Couldn't get back as near his next red as he wanted to be.
57.
But when you can pot like that, what does it matter? Well, that was a real flyer off the side cushion.
Just clean the white.
Yeah, sure.
78.
Well, there are some theories that if there's chalk on the side cushion, it can accelerate the bounce. I think a more likely explanation is that the under table heating gets at the cushion rubber, not everywhere but in certain spots, and that creates the problem. The cannon on that red has made the sentry less probable.
86.
No sentry.
93.
93 does the job, direct from Williams' disastrous break-off shot. 2-1 to Robertson. Bob Spencer, the referee, giving each of the colours a quick polish in his gloves, hoping to reduce the incidence of kicks. Just a safety. That's left to cut the corner on. Overcut, in fact. Attempted the pot, but there was a natural path through the other balls and back towards Bourke. Bourke being the area behind the line on which three low value colours sit when they're all on their spots. Too thick. Nothing easy left though. Made sure he potted the red. Position was always problematic and requiring a favourable run of the ball. Well, unlucky to go in off. Still, hasn't left an easy starter. Cannon on the yellow has left this red within potting distance for Robertson. Pink not available, black not available, but by means of the deep screw he gave himself a couple of possibilities in the other half of the table. That's got the pink into play for later. This is the last of the easy reds.
33.
More precise positional play is going to be required for the others. May not have done him any good unless the near red goes past the black. Which it didn't. Nice cannon to bring another red into play. Couldn't do much with that because it was straight. Good pop to keep the break going. well, that had to be played at pace to get that side of the black. But it was difficult at such a narrow angle. Still, Williams has pulled up to only four behind. Not what he intended. I think he was playing the red to the left hand side cushion. Plays the blue, can't avoid the pink. He needs to be on the right hand side of the table. Could have got there had he potted the green. Pot and to take a chance of position. As it turned out, he was on the black.
Eight.
Chance to level the match at 2-2. That needs to be a good shot. From yellow to green. A much bigger bounce than he expected, but it could work in his favour because now the angle on the green is taking him towards the brown. Pot wasn't easy though. Williams leads by five as he tries to take the match to a fifth frame decider. For the frame there, expected to get the green the way he played it.
Three.
But here's a chance for Robertson to win the match, although he would prefer the cue ball to be either further from the side cushion or at a slightly wider angle. Used quite a bit of power, so he's on the blue and he would need only pink in addition. So Neil Robertson gets off the mark in group two by beating Mark Williams by three frames to one. We'll take a short break now, and Williams will return to this table to play Anthony McGill.